Roadware 10-minute concrete mender easy injection mixers make full depth repairs in hairline cracks without cutting. This less evasive crack repair technique breaks the rules for concrete repair. Broken rule number one, hairline cracks are not worth the trouble fixing. Broken rule number two, you have to cut open a hairline crack if you want to actually repair it. Broken rule number three, crack injection requires pumps, ports, slow epoxy, and lots of time. Let's look at these rules one by one. Broken rule number one, hairline cracks are not worth the trouble fixing. Did you know that every crack in concrete starts out as a hairline crack, some so fine you can't even see them with the naked eye? Cracking naturally occurs in concrete slabs as the concrete cures and shrinks. We use saw cuts and control joints to encourage the concrete to crack inside the saw cuts or the tool joints. The problem is concrete doesn't always listen. It can crack anywhere it wants to crack. We don't like it, but that's the way it is. The truth is, we would fix hairline cracks if there was a good and efficient way to do it. Most of the time, we ignore hairline cracks and blame them on the nature of concrete. When we say things like, it will be fine, you still have aggregate interlock, and the crack is just on the surface. Or, concrete cracks, and that's just the nature of the product. Check out our new floor coatings. The customer who just invested in a new concrete floor is never happy with these answers. Broken rule number two, you have to cut open a crack if you really want to repair it. A repair material has to actually get into a crack so it'll actually do some good. Anything short of that is no better than caulk. Traditional cut and cover techniques use a diamond saw blade to open up the crack, forming a shallow well for concrete mender to accumulate and flow down into the crack. It works really well, and Roadware has been doing this for over 20 years. What is needed is a way to actively push repair products into hairline cracks. With a few simple techniques and Roadware easy injection mixers, Roadware 10-minute concrete mender can do the job. That brings us to rule number three. Crack injection requires pumps, ports, slow epoxy, and lots of time. For a successful injection repair, you need to accomplish three things. Delivery of the materials to the repair area. The repair material needs to set before it flows away from the repair area. And the repair has to be structurally effective. Roadware easy injection mixers makes getting concrete mender into cracks as small as 20 mil, that's the width of two business cards, simple. Just drill a 3/8-inch hole into the crack and push the nearly water-thin concrete mender deep into the cracks. You can actually watch the concrete mender flow along the length of the hairline crack. Leave the expensive injection pumps in the shop. A cartridge of concrete mender and a manual application gun is all you will need. Roadware 10-minute concrete mender starts to thicken and cure in about 5 minutes after application, so the material will stay where you put it. Traditional injection epoxies take hours to cure. In many cases, at the end of the day, the epoxy all ends up under the slab and no longer in the crack. Roadware 10-minute concrete mender with microdolling penetrates traditional bond lines and repairs concrete from the inside out. Epoxy injection resins become very hard and brittle. As the concrete deflects under traffic, the brittle epoxy will start grinding away at the bond line and deterioration will start all over again. Roadware 10-minute concrete mender is designed to restore aggregate interlock and deflect with the concrete under heavy traffic and loading. The structure of polyurethane will not become brittle over time and is designed to bring cracked concrete back to the original pre-crack condition. So these are the three rules of concrete repair you can break when using Roadware 10-minute concrete mender. Comments, please leave them below. Please subscribe to our channel and we'll see you next time.